second day of our new tour, and it's so good to be on the road again. It feels so good to perform for you guys. And, you know, I spent the last, you know, prior to this, I spent the last year working on a brand new album that just came out. I'm super excited about it. Thank you. The album is called Brave Enough, and this next song I'm going to play for you is it's one of the singles for the album, and the video hasn't quite come out yet, but you guys are going to get a little sneak peek of some of the footage that I filmed for the music video, so this is Prism.
Thank you. I'll fix that.
Okay, you have 2.5 minutes.
So you know your sign, the Brave Enough sign, the bee fell off.
The bee fell off.
The bee. So that's the Brave Enough tour. I think it's an improvement. Also,
Luna pooped in your shoes.
Which ones?
The ones you're wearing.
And, two of your dancers are down. I don't know if you heard that whole thing.
Are they okay?
Three are down. Something to do with a pogo stick. I don't know. Anyway, break a leg, kid.
Oh my gosh, okay. What the? You guys, I'm having the worst night of my life. I mean, this is a train wreck. And you guys are back here with... Are those pickles?
Called pickle brining. Great for the bags under your eyes.
Oh. Great, yeah, I'm having a panic attack. I need some water.
No,
oh,
those are ours.
No.
Well, hey, we got pickle juice.
Oh, my dress, kit, my costume. Just got pickle juice all over my costume. What am I gonna do? Sorry about your waters.
You get the bottles.
Hey, Drew.
Yeah.
Did you know pickles have more vitamin C than any other fruit?
Far out, man.
Hey, Drew.
Yeah?
What do you call a pickle on sale?
I don't know.
Sweet dill.
Wait, I don't get it.
Okay, fresh start. Taking this one step at a time. I have a new dress. And not bad for a tablecloth, if I do say so myself. Okay, deep breath. You can do this, Lindsey. Violin, please.
Sorry, Lindsey, your violin's broken.
You dropped it.
Are you kidding?
Lindsey, will you sign my violin?
Sorry. Hollywood's a tough town, kid.
Violin. This is not a toy. This is a violin for children. And it's about the size of violin that I started on. I started playing the violin when I was 6 years old. And so for nostalgia's sake, I'm gonna play you guys the first violin that I ever, or the first song I ever learned on violin. Oh. Nice of you guys to show up. Yeah, I guess that'll do. Than your normal outfits, if I can do that much. Okay. Alright. Yeah, could you please give me an A, please?
Thank you.
casting.
I forgot Skyrim, sorry.
You forgot Skyrim?
It's never said it better, Lindsey.
Thank you. Wait, what? Oh, man. Okay, I think this is a perfect opportunity for me to introduce you to my incredible, fantastic, very talented, and handsome band members. Please, guys, give it up for Drew on the bongos. And give it up for Kit on the kitty keys. Is that your new travel rig?
Yeah, my budget got cut.
Or it's the latest technology. Everything's getting smaller these days. All right, well, we're going to play you guys on some of our real instruments. All right, here's the ropes. Okay. Style. We're going to play it in an acoustic arrangement, and this song actually was originally written for the Disney film Pete's Dragon, which I was super excited to work with on this. It's always been kind of a dream to work with Disney, or to be a Disney princess. And as close as I'll ever get is writing a song for Disney. I don't think I'll ever be a princess. But this, you guys, is Something Wild. I'll tell you though, the one that has all the power in this room.
in the back with the lighting. And I have to say, Andy is the man. Please stand up for Andy in the back. I really am so grateful for my team. I have the most talented and incredible people working with me on this tour, and you know, some of us have been together from my very first ever show, and we've just built this amazing team from there. And you know, this whole thing, it takes you know, every day it takes about 20 people to make this happen every night. And so, anyways, I'm so grateful for everyone that's on my tour, and really we are like a family. And you get so close when you're on the road together. And this next song actually is written in memory of my keyboard player. For those of you who don't know, my keyboard player from the very first show I ever had up until last fall, he passed away unexpectedly. And he was my best friend. And it was one of the hardest, it probably was the hardest single most thing I've ever experienced, was losing him. And, you know, I had just barely started writing my album when he passed away. And I remember thinking, you know, we had talked about writing together. He was going to help me write this album. And, you know, he had been sick. And when he was in the hospital, I kept promising him that we would write. As soon as he was healthy, as soon as he was out of the hospital, we were going to write my album together and work together. And there was one song that we had just barely started. One time, it was actually on the road, in a sound check one day, we came up with this melody that we loved, and, you know, he passed away before we got to finish it, and, I remember being so bummed that he, you know, for so many reasons, I miss him so much, but, in honor of him, I finished this song, and, through many experiences, I've come to be reaffirmed. I've always believed that there is life after this. I'm a very religious and very spiritual person, and I know that we live before this, and that this life is just a small piece of eternity. And I know that my friend Gavi has been with me. He's helping me. He's along the way, and he helped me finish this song. So this is Gavi's song.
We love Gavi! Yeah.
Thank you so much. You know, I think anytime you experience a huge loss, there's a series of emotions you go through, and it hurt so bad to lose someone that at first, my initial instinct was I just went numb. And I realized that it actually felt a lot better to not feel anything than to feel pain. But I've read these books by Brené Brown, and she's become a hero of mine, and she talks about how you cannot selectively numb emotions. If you numb the bad, you'll also numb the good. And life isn't about only being happy all the time. Life is about feeling the full spectrum of emotions so that you can have empathy and you can learn to have hope and courage in spite of all the things that we deal with. And so this album is actually written about me learning to feel again, because I went so numb and I was so scared to open up. And that's why the album is called Brave Enough. It's about being brave enough to live with a whole heart and let your heart be out there and be vulnerable. And so each song on the album, it starts off and tells a story. The beginning of the album is Lost Girls, and it starts off very cold and lost and timid like I was. And then each song progressively is a step of the process, thematically and musicality-wise. It gets warmer and tells my story of how I became braver, and hopefully someday I'll reach the state that's at the end of the album, and I think it's going to be a lifelong journey to get there. But one of the songs was I realized that I could be bitter and angry about all these, you know, these things that happen in life that are wrong, you know, losing my best friend, or I suddenly became very grateful. I was filled with gratitude for the amazing memories that I had with Gavi. You know, he had tons of friends, so many people loved him, and yet I got to travel the world with him. He changed my life, he made me think of life in a whole new way, and view life. Where every day of his life he thought was the best day of his life. He was so optimistic and he was so full of gratitude. And it made me realize that I needed to be grateful for the amazing good times I have. So this song is written about my memories of the good times. And it gave me hope for the future that there will be so many more amazing times ahead. This song is called Those Days.
Thank you.
difficulties, ladies and gentlemen. But don't worry, I have a plan B. For times such as this, I have a special assistant so that my crew can figure out what is going wrong. So I'd like to, actually, I need to ask you as a favor. This is one of the most important members of our crew. But she's very shy. Very shy. So when she comes out, I'm going to ask you guys not to cheer too loudly for her. All right. Luna?
Luna!
Luna, come here, baby! Come here, baby! Come on! Oh, she's thinking that. Luna!
Here you are.
All right, Luna. Sit. Sit. A golf clap, please, for Luna, everybody. Girl, here's your treat. She's not sure if she wants it. All right. Oh, I'm so proud right now. I'm a proud mom. We've been working on this for the last 2 weeks. All right, Luna. Let's show them. This is the big grand finale moment, everybody. Okay. Luna, up. Come on. Come on. Come on, up. Come on, right there. Everyone, a golf clap, please, for Luna Latte! I think the reason she's so slow is she's like, I hate this costume. Why would you do this to me? I was actually up all night the other night making this lovely suit coat to match my own. What daughter doesn't want to match her mother, right? Luna, she really is the closest thing I have to a child, as pathetic as that is. I'm one of those people. Moved to LA and got a Chihuahua. But, Luna's a little rescue dog, and right now I'm having such a proud mom moment that she was able to do her tricks. Everybody give it up for Luna! I think the internet provides such a stomping ground for people to criticize other people. And, you have nameless people that just troll the internet and say nasty things all the time because there's no accountability for it. And there's a quote that I love that you'll hear momentarily, but it talks about the fact that the people, the nameless and the faceless critic, the critics might say, all I gotta say is I was told by so many critics that I would never make it, there was no market for a dancing violinist. I was also told that I sounded like drowned rats when I played my violin by many people. And I want to tell you that the opinions of the critics actually don't count. So that's what this next song is about. It's about the fighter that's actually willing to dare greatly.
It's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit goes to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes up short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcomings. Thank you. opposed to the man who is actually in the arena.
Thank you. That was insane, man.
Insane, my friend.
Estuvo espectacular. That was just awesome. Awesome.
Spaghetti Western than we planned, but it's kind of cool.
Thank you.
feels really awkward when you play acoustically, we just discovered. I have to close that. Can't just resolve. I have to resolve this. Okay. Sorry. Guys, thank you for coming so much. Thank you for being here today. This is our second show of the tour, and it's already been so much fun, so I can't wait to show you what we've got planned and what we've been working on, and yep, stay tuned, it'll be coming soon.
Thank you. All right.
Happy birthday to you, dear Lindsey. Happy birthday to you.